Good morning, CJA students, and welcome to your daily examine. We are glad that you are here. Remember that you are here, this matters, and you are going to get the best of me right now. Each day we start off the examine to reflect on either our upcoming day or our previous day, where we see God, creating our list of gratitude, naming our emotions so we can control them, figuring out a message behind one of our emotions, and offering an intention. So, let's start off right now by being aware of God's presence, remember He is always with us, and asking ourselves where I've seen God today or yesterday. List three places. You could see God in nature, you could see God in people, you could see God in different things. It could be a time or a place. Try and see God in everything. Remember, the ultimate goal of our lives is to live with God forever. You're at the 9 minute mark, which means hopefully you've written down at least one or two things or places where you've seen God. If you're not finished with that section, don't worry, but let's move on to our list of gratitude. It is good to be thankful. It is good to recognize the gifts that we have in our lives. Try and think very hard right now. What are things that you are grateful for? Try to list three. Try and say, I'm grateful for my mom because she showers me with love every single day. I'm grateful for my friends because they are there for me when I need it the most. It could be a person, a place, a thing, but try and dig deep. And also try and list the quick reason why you're grateful for that thing, person, or place. It could also be a time. I'm grateful for my bed because it provides me comfort when I sleep. Perhaps even think of things that we might take for granted. I'm grateful for the gift of smell because each morning I get to wake up and smell the wonderful breakfast that somebody's cooked for me. I'm grateful for the ability to read and write because I can express my thoughts and feelings to other people. Even on days when you don't feel like writing out what you're grateful for, even on days where you feel kind of bummed out, remember, you still have gifts in your life. You are still blessed. Hopefully we've wrapped up our list of gratitude. Now we're going to go on to naming our emotions. We name our emotions so that we can control them or come up with a plan when we anticipate that they might happen throughout the day. So you're going to name the emotion that you felt, and then quickly list the time and place. You don't have to be as specific as possible, but just general, the time and place where that occurred. And to help you out so you don't just say happy, sad, mad all the time, we have this beautiful list of emotions. So yeah, you could start with happy, sad, bad, angry, but then try and build out. Maybe sad becomes lonely, or guilty, or hurt. Maybe happy becomes accepted, powerful, peaceful. Maybe angry becomes humiliated, aggressive, frustrated. And then you could build out even further. Maybe if you were surprised, you were shocked, dismayed, astonished. Maybe if you were happy, you were curious. Maybe you were confident. Maybe you were courageous. Maybe if you were sad, you felt isolated, powerless, remorseful, disappointed. Try and build your vocabulary over time. Remember to pick the time and the place where these emotions occur. As you wrap up your list of emotions, now we come to the most important part of the exam, the message behind one of the emotions. This is where you can come up with a plan to attack your day, right? This could have happened yesterday, you could anticipate it happening, but maybe the message behind exhausted is that I need to set an alarm for myself to go to bed earlier, get away from the screens. Maybe the message behind content is I want to surround myself with good people that bring positive energy to my life. Maybe the message behind irritated is that I need to learn to let things go and not be so invested in trying to get back at somebody. This is the part of the examine where you identify that emotion that is either positive, neutral, or negative in your life, and you try and come up with a plan to either keep it happening or maybe avoid it. As we move on to our last section, it's time to offer some intentions or ask for help. Remember that prayers do things. Your prayer may not be answered in your time, it may be answered in God's time. So God, please help me too, or God, I would like to pray for. It could be for yourself, to help you get through the rest of the day, to help you accomplish a goal, to help you be disciplined, to be focused. It could be for somebody else. Maybe there's somebody out there that's hurting and really needs your intention. Here's an opportunity to be a person for others. Offer up an intention for them so that maybe their day gets a little bit easier. If you find that you have finished early, try and go back to the boxes. See if you can add a little bit more. If you're fine, you're a little bit behind, that's okay. There's no rush here. Just reflecting on yesterday, today, and the day to come. As always, go ahead and circle up at the bottom if you felt that you gave your best effort on this self-reflection. Yes or no? Thank you. And then if you noticed or wondered anything during the examine, this is optional. You could write it down. Maybe you were feeling some type of way. Maybe you were noticing that this gift popped up constantly. And if you find that you've gotten a lot of time left, look at this mantra over and over again. I am focused. I am strong. I am blessed. I can do it. And as you do that, breathe each time you say it. And you can use this space to kind of color in. I find it very soothing and a way to just kind of focus and settle my body and prepare for the day. I would like to thank you for doing the examine with us today. Remember that you are loved and that you are a gift of God. Have a wonderful rest of your day.